everyone. I am your host, MeleeWizard. And before I get into the game itself, there are a few things that I want to say. Mostly because this game in particular leads into perhaps one of the primary reasons why I've started doing Let's Plays in the first place. The other main reason was to try to get me to stop being as much of a recluse as I tend to be, and I like to think that's worked to some extent, but the other reason is something that I've noticed over the years, and it's kind of been unsettling for me. Because, like, when I was younger, I could play a game for, like, hours on end and not think anything of it. But as the years have gone by, I've noticed that my attention span has deteriorated significantly to the point where there have been a few cases where I've started a game and never finished it. And at one point, I figured, what better way to actually finish what I start than to record myself playing it and put it up on YouTube? And this has actually already paid dividends in regards to games like Sword of Mana and Treasure of the Rudras, which I had started but had never beaten before doing my Let's Play of them. And also games like Section Z and, I believe, Swords and Serpents, where I had beaten them, just never without resorting to cheat codes. And this game in particular is one that I've been wanting to Let's Play for years. I mean, even as far back as when I was doing, like, Final Fantasy II, this game had always been in the back of my mind, to the point where I had committed to doing an eventual blind Let's Play of this for so long, I had made it a point not to look up spoilers or other people's Let's Plays of this. So I hope you're considerate of that and not spoil things for me too much. And with that, I bring to you Let's Play Mother 1. Oh boy, I have a feeling this is going to be a train wreck, and you know what? I really don't care. Because I've been wanting to play pretty much this entire series for a long time, and I knew that if I didn't do a Let's Play of this, I probably would never finish it. And I'm using the Game Boy Advance version, which includes Mother 2. And for those who don't know, this stuff is also known as Earthbound Zero and Earthbound. And there is one main reason why I'm using the Game Boy Advance version, and it'll become apparent rather quickly. And start a new game. Yeah, I'll just... And I'll just leave those as default. Favorite food, I'll go with pasta, why not? In the early 1900s, a dark shadow fell over a rural town in America. Shortly after, a married couple mysteriously vanished. The man's name was George. The woman's name was Maria. 2 years later, George returned home, but never told anyone where he had been or what he had done. Instead, he deeply immersed himself in strange research. As for his wife, Maria, she never returned. 1988, outside the town of Mother's Day. Okay, and this is the... There we go. Found the easy ring. I'm gonna have to get used to the controls here. I'm gonna go ahead and equip the easy ring. Well, what the easy ring does, it increases XP and money from enemies and reduce random battles. This is probably the main reason why I'm using the Game Boy Advance version as opposed to the NES version, just because this will make grinding easier / not as long. So is there anything here? No. Oh dear. Just go ahead and fight the thing. Whoa, a critical hit already? That didn't kill it, okay. Ah. Oh dear, that's not good. Did I not get experience for that? Yes, I did. Okay, it just didn't show me how much. Yeah, go ahead and fight another lamp, why not? Yeah, I think I go ahead and just do auto and just let it do the combat up. Since this is all pretty straightforward. Uh-oh. Okay. Now the easy ring didn't say I took less damage. So I'm hoping that the ant fights themselves aren't necessarily easier because of this. Yeah, you think? Yeah, this is such a lovely thing. Okay, so that brings up that. Telepathy? Huh. Yeah, so I'm hitting the L button is basically like the check button or what or whatever. So oh dear. Yeah, as per usual in my RPGs I do, I'll probably be cutting out a lot of these random battles. Unless either it's a new enemy that I hadn't seen before, or something interesting happens. But in these little early tutorial things, might as well just show the whole darn thing. Wow, that was a lot of experience there. Fight, what, 3, speed 2, wisdom 2, strength 2, force 3. Oh dang, okay, I did level up twice. I wonder if there's a way to make this text go by faster. Ah, learned a new sigh. And okay, I got healing. Good. Good. Oh, really? Okay, and I think these melodies are kind of important, but that's assuming I actually find them all. Oh. Okay. Yeah, sure. I see. Sounds like it must have been a poltergeist of some sort. Fun. I'm not sure what to do about it either, but your great-grandfather did study Psi at one point. Perhaps there's something in the basement that could help make sense of things. I know I put the basement key somewhere, but I don't remember where. Okay. So, yeah, things locked. Let's see, we can talk to the dog, can't we? Yes, we can. Aha! Key to the basement. Yeah, the R button doesn't seem to do much, and I think I get free healing here while I'm at home, don't I? Yep, that did heal me up. Good. Our start is for the map. There we go. Great-grandfather's diary. Cracked bat. Good. and found bread. Go ahead and equip the cracked bat, because that will definitely be useful. So what does the bread do? Indeed, you can use its crumbs to mark a trail that you can retrace later. So in case something that in theory would prevent me from getting lost, I guess? Most of the diary is unreadable, but one part did stand out. The password. Where is the god's tail? That which was left behind by the ship that soars the heavens. Okay. Much confusion. Wasn't there a way for me to store items or something? Or am I confusing it with something else? Is there anything in here? No. Okay. So how much money do I have? $100. Okay. And I need 18 XP. Yes, I will save! Okay, so what does this say? My house, of course. So now I'm wondering about these random battles, because like I said, I have played some of this, and for those who know the game, I've only gotten as far as rescuing Pippi, so you know I've got a long ways to go. Speaking of which, tell the mayor, okay. That's... And I can't go in the house, alright. So, do I... Oh, hello, redneck. Well, actually, no, there was a setup thing. Maybe that's where I can change the, Aha! There we go. That's much better. Yeah, I'm definitely doing a good bit of damage. And I leveled up again. Alright. Oof, went up 13. Now, I'm wondering if this applies to just me or the other members of my party whenever they show up. That is a legitimate concern. Okay. Well, might as well talk to the people. Oh, really? So it wasn't just my house. And yeah, so each town is a holiday or something relating to it, and there's a whole lot of different places to go. Okay. Ah. No, I didn't. No, I didn't come from the cemetery. Let's see. Nope, I'm not in the city boundary now. I think that is a zombie. I think I remember that much. And the hotel. $30 a night? Nah. $39 is cheap? Oh dear. Okay. Is there anything else in here? No, doesn't look like it. And I don't think I can I can take stuff from the drawers. Might as well see what else we got going on in town. Oh, the animals have turned violent. Okay, and the... Yeah, that's not good. Canary Village? Okay. Yeah, but if the animals have gone violent, I don't think I want to go there. Oh, what do we have here? I guess. Ah, I've got food, which I'm sure is their, healing items. Good to know. Okay. Obviously that's probably going to be me. Oh, Town Hall. Here we go. Okay. That was the mayor's assistant. I don't know, the task might be too much for you to handle, but I still have high hopes for you anyway. Well, you see, a child has strayed into the cemetery. And as luck would have it, I'm up for re-election soon. Of course you are. Yeah, sure. Oh, you'll do it? You'll go and rescue her? Come back alive and you'll be a hero. I'd go with you, but I'm, not feeling well. And it's hard to be re-elected if you're dead. Do you have anything else to say? No. Oh, there's someone living in Canary Village. Alright. A PTA card. Now, thankfully, I do have an ATM card. So... let's see. Here we go. Okay, so... I thought I could... no. Okay, so I thought I could deposit items somewhere, but I guess not. So, and we've got asthma spray. That sounds like fun. All very expensive, of course. Oh, sports goods. I think those are weapons, aren't they? Yes. Slingshot and T-ball bat. Alright. Can afford the slingshot, but I don't even know if I can even use it. Orange juice for sports drink. Okay. And a pet store. Except we... 85... What? Ah, there. Right. Okay. Just give me a dang canary, huh? Yeah, I am going to get so confused over the course of this thing, but given the nature of this game, it really shouldn't be that surprising. And I have to spend money to use the payphone, obviously. No. Songs. So I guess that's one reason for me to go there. Oh, I already talked to you. Oh. Ah. There we go. Is there any other places I can go to? I am not sure. Is there any other places? Oh, there's a hospital. And... okay. Let's see what we got here. Maybe this is where they go if they get knocked out or something? No. Nope, nothing here. And nothing here. Alright. So is that everything to be had here? I think... Whoop, here's somebody. Not yet. I'm on it, though. Okay, so I'm still in town, technically. Though I don't think... most likely. Okay. And I think that's a zombie, and I don't want to talk to him because that'll initiate a fight, and I'm not sure I would survive it. And I think with that, I'm going to go ahead, head back home, and rest and save, and see what other enemies pop up. I think having extra XP and gold from fights, that's going to definitely make things a bit more streamlined than they would otherwise be. Oh, so never it actually does tell me how much XP and gold I get. Well, the gold I understand because I don't have access to it immediately anyway, but... Oh, jeez, really? We got the hippie. Alright. Uh-oh. Your attack went up by 8 and you only did 1 damage? I thought the easy ring was supposed to... Uh-oh. I think... Dang it. Uh-oh. What? What the heck did I learn? Hypnosis. Okay, so how do I... So what does telepathy do? So apparently if I stray off the path, that's when enemies will attack me, because I think. Maybe? I'm not sure. Wait, where the heck am I? Okay. Oh, a snake. Fun. Ooh, I one-shotted him! Nice! And... Okay, what else did I learn? Oh. Life, healing, so I'm guessing that's... I'm guessing that would heal poison or something? Huh. And then I leveled up, okay. 3... Is there no way of for me to know... What these things do. Huh. Wait, oh, okay. Thought I was... Where am I going? Where the heck am I going? Don't think I'm going the right way. Yeah, I don't think I'm going the right way now. Because I don't remember the path being quite this winding. Oh, a smoking crow. Okay. Yep, going the wrong way. Alright, so I'm safe in town. So I think I have to go up here. Well. Aha, I think here's. Yep, okay, I'm going the right way now. Yeah, I'm gonna get so lost in this thing. But I might as well try telepathy and see if that does anything. Doesn't appear to. Okay. So I think I might grind out another level, maybe? Because even though I'm definitely a higher level than I would be if I wasn't, I didn't have the easy ring, but... Oh, dang, I've got a good bit of money now. This level, I need 22, okay. And I guess with that, I'm gonna end things off here. So, I guess join me next time when I head out for the cemetery. Oh boy, this is gonna be a thing. So I guess until next time, this is MeleeWizard, and have a nice day.